Hey guys, welcome back. So today I'm going plant shopping and I am also going thrifting. First, I'm going to Oakdale Greenhouse. They recently posted that they had some kind of hard to find Hoyas. Two specifically that I'm interested in that I have not seen anywhere before in the Charlotte area. And then after I do some plant shopping at Oakdale Greenhouse, I'm planning to go thrifting. I usually hit up some Goodwills and I'm always really surprised at the amazing planty stuff I can find. I typically look for wicker baskets, planters, you know, just really good planty stuff, and I tend to have pretty big hauls at the end of these videos, so make sure you stick around for that. If you don't know me, welcome. My name is Ashley, and as you can see, I am obsessed with all things houseplants, and I'm a crazy plant person, so if that brings a smile to your face, you may want to subscribe. That's the only way for my videos to show up in your newsfeed, and I'm also on Instagram, and we are so close to the plant giveaway. Once I hit 10,000 followers on Instagram, like I said, I'm doing a really cool plant giveaway. Something rare, hard to find, an uncommon plant. So maybe give me a follow on Instagram if that's something you are interested in. So I am planning to pick up quite a few things on my shopping today, and there's no way I could be doing it without our amazing sponsor for this video. Our amazing sponsor today is Morning Brew. Like all the sponsors on my channel, I absolutely love Morning Brew, and I actually use them every single day, but they are a little different than other sponsors. They are a free email that you receive Monday through Sunday, so every single day, and you get your email and it updates you on all of the news and current events of the day. So it actually makes the news really, you know, a lot more enjoyable to read. Every morning, the first thing I do is my first 5 minutes of the day as I read through the articles. It's an absolute pleasure kind of going through, getting up to date with everything that's going on, and then I'm ready to get going on my day. A couple articles that I read about just today were the Richard Branson going into space, so cool, and then about all about the upcoming Olympics. But they have all sorts of interesting stuff about tech, about finance, about business, about marketing. As I mentioned, Morning Brew is a completely free subscription service that takes about 15 seconds to sign up for. So there's no reason not to sign up if you're interested in business, finance, or tech. I've included the link to subscribe for you guys in my description below. Thank you again to Morning Brew for sponsoring this episode. I know you guys are going to love them. So with that said, I am ready to go do some plant shopping. Like I said, first I'm gonna hit up Oakdale and then do some thrifting at Goodwills. So let's go. So here we are in their Hoya section, and their Hoyas here. There are, looks like, a couple plants I'm interested in. Specifically, really interested in a Hoya Chelsea, and they're $20. And it looks like they have some, you know, that it's not just a little baby cutting. It's actually some nice sized ones for $20 and can never find them. So like this one's a nice size. Has a couple plants in there. Hoya Chelsea. The other one I'm interested in is the Lacanosa, but I don't see any around, but I'm gonna look and maybe I'll get lucky. Hoya Shepherdii, they are 19. Bilobata. Look how cute that Bilobata is. The leaves are so fuzzy and adorable. I love it. $19.95. Hoya Australis, they are $19. Oh my gosh, it looks like they might have one left. I think this is Hoya Lacanosa. Look how cute. I don't see any other ones and it's not labeled. But I think this might be a Lacanosa. If so, I'm definitely gonna be taking that one home with me today. Hoya Carnosa Queen. Puba Calyx. Some larger size Bilobatas over there. Then we have Wyettii. Some large size Hoya Carnosas there. They are $35. Hindu Rope. $45. Some larger size Australis Lisa, or yeah, this one is not oh my gosh, just Australis, not Lisa. $48. I did buy one of these from here and it has put out so much new growth. Oh my goodness. Puba Calyx, they are $40. All right, so they have a bunch of other little Wyettias here. They are $20. Hoya Retusas, some more Compactas. Nice Ripsalis. These big baskets are $14.95. That's a good deal. have this, I guess it's called German Ivy. It is $10. Wow, look at these gorgeous rickrack cactus. They're $45. Lots of string of pearls and string of tears, string of dolphins, all $7. String of bananas, gorgeous cacti. Look at this euphorbia. We have a bunch of string of hearts, $11.95. String of turtles. They have the small ones here, they're $6. And then these 4-inch pots, they are $14.95. On to this next greenhouse. They have the Tradescantia. These are lipstick, Columnia hirta. Look at this huge cane begonia up there. They have all sorts of amazing plants. These staghorn fern are $9.95. Very healthy, beautiful. They have some Monstera Adansonii, a few Cebu Blues left. Pothos Trubii Moonlight. So many peperomias. As you can see here, they have a wide variety of them. Vanilla orchid here, there's 17. Christmas cactus, Raphidophora tetrasperma, ficus golden gem, 21 for these large size plants. Pilea aluminum plants, $5.95. Some probably a type of pixie syngonium, which is just a very small size leaf compared to normal. We have some other syngoniums over here. Dracaena. All of these are different varieties of Tradescantia. We have tricolor. Lavender here. This lavender one is exceptionally beautiful. This one is white zebra up there. Nanook. These are their varieties of lipstick plants, Rasta, Columnia. I am feeling these Pilea peperomioides. Mine has been struggling and I really love these. Let's see how much these are. Wow, this one is so healthy. $21. All right, $21. All right, guys, that is gonna, I think, be coming home with me. Incredible. Alocasia bambino coming into their begonias. Begonia Morocco, Lois Burke. Look at those little polka dots on those leaves. Begonia torch pink. Benigo pink. Look at these looking glass ones. Oh, beautiful. Sophia. Frosty. Maculata. And Linda Dawn. So right when you first walk in, they have a bunch of philodendron micans in 6-inch pots. They're $29.95. And they have Raphidophora decursiva or dragon tail. I just purchased one from here recently and it's already getting fenestrations and it's put out a bunch of new leaves. These are super healthy. These are uncommon plants and these are $69. But as you can see, like this one here, this one here is already getting some fenestrations. So the bigger the leaves get, the more mature, the more it'll put off those. And it loves to climb. Ficus triangularis over there, Philodendron Prince of Orange, loads of Monstera deliciosas, Ficus teneke here, $39.95. Wow, this Philodendron giganteum is $34. That's pretty cool. Fast growing plant. Wow, look at these beautiful philodendrons. That one back there is an Imperial Red. I'm not sure if this is a large Prince of Orange or maybe a Macaulay's Finale. Gosh, they're so pretty. Look at all that red. ZZ Zenzies here, they are 24, and then we have a regular ZZ plants. So many Sansevieria. My goodness, such an incredible selection here. I'm so tempted to get one of these huge Zebrinas. They are $30. And they're massive, like absolutely massive, just stunning. They have these large baskets of Scandapsis Exotica or Silver Satin. They are $34.95. Then we also have some Mycans here. Omelo. Mena Emerald Green, Marble Queen Pothos, Neon Pothos. Looks like they have quite a bit of furniture in stock, and I was looking at this little table. This little table is cute. It's missing some glass in the top. Kind of boho-ish. That's neat. I also like this white. I don't know what it is, but it's perfect for hanging plants. Hang your plants on there and needs a little TLC. The bottom's kind of messed up, but I think that's kind of neat. Wow, this sideboard is so pretty and it's $24. That's amazing. Some wicker baskets up there. Looks like there are a couple little planters here. Some vases. This one's nice. $2.99. Same from IKEA. Like IKEA, you can get new ones for that price. This one's cute. I think this is nice. That's a candle in there still. It's cute though. These aren't bad. I wish they were white, but there's two of them. They're a nice size, 4 or 5 inch pots. I also like this colorful one. I think that's pretty. $2.99. This guy's cute. This black one back here is nice. Oh yes, that's a good one. Little pails. This little flowers and garden one is adorable. It's kind of an interesting planter. More like a vase, I think. That one's nice. Ooh, I like this one. Thank you. Looking over here in their glassware section, see what they have going on. These are always great for propagations. There's usually some nice stuff. I like that. 79 cents. Little vase. There's lots of little vases and that kind of thing. I'm more just interested in planters. Little kettle, little flowers on there. Quite cute. Kind of sweet. Kind of browsing through, see what I can find. These actually would probably make good little plant stands. $1.99, some silver. I don't know. Oh, this one's cool. Cute little gold one here. I use little planters like that all the time. Cash pots. They have a couple cute things over here in their furniture section. I found this basket. It's really nice, $5. I could put a plant in there. You know, there's all sorts of stuff I could do with this. They have this little stand here, $10. Perfect plant stand. I found this, and it's a little basket, but I was thinking I could flip it over and put a plant on there. This little thing is so cute. It has hearts on it, and you could hang plants on there. I'm not sure what it's supposed to be used for, maybe towels or something. And it's $4.99. That is adorable. This is so cute. These bookends are neat. What is this? $2.99. It's a pretty big planter. Spray paint it, whatever color. What else do we have here? Some candle holders. Up here for $3.99, there are a few little containers. Some little baskets up here. Cute little mugs. See what else I can find. Oh, here's a Christmas planter. Little vase there. This is cute. Looks like a little is that a Monstera leaf platter? That's nice. $3.99, Monstera leaf platter. Cute. Some little hanging planters. see what else we've going on. Some glassware for propagations. This pink one is $3.99. Looks like it had a plant in there recently. This is kind of cool. I like the way that looks. Looks like there are a bunch of other planters here. This one, $3.99. This one is $3.99. I could use that. This one, $2.99. So yeah, looks like there's some good stuff here for plants. This little one here. Got this purpley one. It's cute. And okay. Oh, find some good stuff. This one is cool. $3.99. Interesting. The black. This is just a standard black one back there. Oh, white one. That apple is cute. Turn that into something. It's huge though. They have these cute little cups here, which are perfect to propagate with. So I'll probably take these home with me. Not sure how much these are, but you could take the lids off. Thinking it would be great little plant holders, cover pots. It's $14, but I think that's from the store. All right, I just got back. Oh my gosh, that was so amazing. I cannot wait to show you my haul. There are so many things to show you, so I am going to jump into it. First, I'm gonna start with the plants that I picked up from Oakdale. First up is this Hoya Chelsea. Isn't she a cutie? So I do actually have some cuttings of a Hoya Chelsea, but they're pretty small, and I've always wanted like a nice sized Hoya Chelsea. They're so beautiful. They have the little dips in the leaves, and they're heart-shaped Hoyas. With Hoyas, when you have the stems that are growing out like this and don't have the leaves on them yet, that's great news because that is actually new growth. And what the plant will do is once it puts out the trailers, then it will start to add leaves. It has some little baby leaves starting. Hoyas are so easy to care for. The vast majority of them are very easy care. I just give it some water. I usually bottom water with Hoyas, and then I let them pretty much dry out, and then I just bottom water them again. It's typically what I do with most of my plants when I bring them home is I give them a good washing off, maybe rub down the leaves a little bit, and then I'll spray it down with neem. And typically I like to keep them separated from my other plants for a little bit, just so I can keep an eye on it, make sure there aren't any pests on there. If I do see pests, you know, Jack's Dead Bug Brew is fantastic. I have beneficial insects in this plant room, so they really do the trick for me. And I have done both recently, green lacewings and ladybugs. And I was more prone to green lacewings, and I've actually switched up, and now my favorite are ladybugs. And I still have tons of stuff to show you guys, but as I'm going through, leave your comments on care tips, because I know not only myself, but other people that look at the comments like to see any suggestions for care. An awesome plant community. So don't hesitate, don't be shy, leave your comments. Oh, $20 for this Hoya Chelsea. I found that to be a really good price. Again, depends where you are in the world. So this next one is another Hoya and was really the main reason I went today, because it's a Hoya lacanosa, and I've never seen one of these out and about. And when I saw that Oakdale Greenhouse had this, I was so surprised, and they only had this one left. You know, they're always getting new shipments in, so you know, if you're interested in that, maybe give them a call, see if they have some more available. But this is a beautiful Hoya. You know, I really like the delicate leaves on this Hoya. They're, as you can see, they're very quaint. They're cute little shape with the little pointies on the end. This one's a bit sun-stressed, which just means that the the leaves are changing, you know, colors and have that beautiful pinkish hue to it, as is typical with sun-stressed Hoyas. And then they have, you know, as you can see, new growth coming out here in a couple of spots, and even has some little leaves and aerial roots happening. So she is a beaut. I'm obsessed. Some more little leaves coming out here. I love this one. It's so delicate, and I just really, really like this one. As with most Hoyas, the blooms on both of these are really stunning. And I've had a couple Hoya blooms this year for the first time ever. The Schipperdii smells like flowers, perfume, absolutely amazing. The the Hoya Matilde, not so much, smelled like pee. I mean, there's no other way to describe it. It was an incredibly strong urine smell. It's very interesting how all the Hoya blooms smell very different. I'm planning to do plant care the same as the Hoya Chelsea. If you have a different experience with this one and I shouldn't, you know, do my typical letting it mostly dry out and then watering it, let me know. So beautiful, look at this thing. So this is a Calathea Zebrina. I do already have a Calathea Zebrina. It's a very small one, but just a trooper. So they were originally $35 on sale for $29 at Oakdale, and they had a ton of them. And I mean, oh my goodness. Calathea Zebrinas, I do water mine with distilled water. As I mentioned in my last video, I'm having to water all of my plants right now with distilled water because I'm having trouble with our tap water being treated with some chemical that was killing all my plants. So distilled water, not a big deal with this guy. And I don't let it completely dry out. When it's starting to look a little wilty, a little bit thirsty, then I just douse it with distilled water so it gets a nice drink. You maybe incorporate a little bit of fertilizer in there, natural fertilizer. But look how beautiful this one is. Oh, I can't get over it. The leaves on Calathea Zebrina are just so stunning. They just are super vibrant, very colorful, have that amazing design, and it feels like what it looks like. They are very, very velvety leaves. Just a real showstopper. I love what the leaves look like when they're coming out. You know, their new growth is so like bursting forth. Hello world, I'm a new leaf coming through. It is absolutely beautiful and massive. I am obsessed with this one. It's going downstairs right when you first walk in the door. Look, hello world, at my beautiful Calathea Zebrina. My only hope is that it will get enough humidity downstairs, so we'll see on that. My experience with Calathea Zebrina, as long as I'm giving it enough water, you know, typically they're okay. I did pick up this beautiful Pilea peperomioides as well. It for $20, it was such a great deal. Absolutely beautiful, so lush. I mean, look at all the little pups it has going on in there. And the last one that I have isn't doing so well, so I forgot to include that in the when I originally filmed, but I did get this one as well. Look at how beautiful it is. Send over your care tips. So that's it for the plants, but I did a lot of thrifting, so let me show you guys what I got from Goodwill. All right, so there's a lot of stuff from thrifting, so I'm just gonna zip through. First of all, look at this amazing basket I found. This was at the last Goodwill that I went to, and I got it for the Calathea Zebrina. I thought it would be perfect. Let's see. I'll do this. Yes! So this was $5 from Goodwill. Really cute. Looks brand new, really. I think that looks fantastic. I did find one more wicker basket, and it's kind of different. Like, I like that. It's really tall. It's kind of skinny. If I did put a plant in here, I'd have to put something in their newspaper or something to fill it up for the most part, and then just put the plant on top. But the other thing I was thinking I could do is flip it over and have it as a plant stand. So there's a lot of options for this one. I'm not quite sure yet. Again, it's in great shape. Looks about new. I mean, these are expensive from even IKEA. They're like $30, so $3.99. And if you do go shopping at Goodwill, make sure to keep an eye out in their furniture section, because that's where I found these two wicker things. So sometimes they're in with the baskets, but keep an eye on the furniture section. Now, all the rest are planters. I got a ton of planters, pardon my French. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 planters. I'm just gonna whip through on those. I found these three, and they're $2.99 each. I think they're kind of cool. They're like an off yellowish color. As I always say, I enjoy getting cover pots without holes in them so that I can bottom water with them. It just makes my life so much easier. And then I just put the nursery pot that the plant's in here. This guy was $5, really nice size one. Yeah, the Syngonium chia pence might work in here. I found this little white one. $1.99, fantastic. Can never have too many of these. Look how cute this one is. It's so colorful and vibrant. I love it. It was $2.99. I just think this one is so much fun. It makes me think of Pride, which just makes me happy. So I was really excited to find this one. And then next up, we have some pots that were kind of grouped together that I think probably came from the same household. And whoever it was had really nice taste because they're really cute. First up is this one. It's a really cute gold and white planter with gold on the inside. Just really adorable with the cute little teardrop details or raindrop detail. $2.99. So cute. Next to it was this one. Again, another gold plant, gold and white theme, which I do have a lot of that already going on in this room. Fantastic cover pot, great size. $2.99. And you can see it was originally from Ross. Another gold and white planter. I was so happy to find these gold and white planters. I really like them. This one has been used, $1.99. And before I use these, I typically like to wash them out and sanitize them for lots of reasons, but in case they've had plants in there that have any pests and stuff, it's better on the safe side and just germs in general from other people these days. I also picked these up. I guess they're shot glasses, but they're really, I think they'd be perfect for propagating. I've been giving away a lot of propagations to people that come over to visit. It was $2.99 for shot glasses. And this is the last thing that I got. I believe it's just a vase that I'm just planning to put flowers in it that I get, but I just thought that was really neat. That was so much fun. I love doing these videos for you guys, and as you can see, every month I kind of have a theme where I try to do a few of my favorite types of videos, which are usually a budget video, a thrifting video, and a big box video, because those are like my favorite ones to film. So make sure you subscribe if you haven't already so you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. At least it'll show up in your newsfeed if you subscribe. Don't forget to give me a follow on Instagram if you're interested in the plant giveaway when we get to 10,000, and we're almost there. Big thank you to Morning Brew for sponsoring this video. Again, it's a free service. It's an email that you receive every day, and it takes about 5 minutes to read through the current events. I really, really love them. That's the first thing I do every day is read my Morning Brew email. So I'm up to date on current events and that kind of thing. So I've included the link in my description below for you guys if you would like to sign up for their daily email. I hope you guys have a fantastic rest of the day. You will definitely be seeing me soon. Bye!